हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस ए चैप्टर ऑफ 12th एनसीईआरटी इंग्लिश बुक फ्लेमिंगो। द चैप्टर इज डीप वाटर, रिटन बाय विलियम डगलस। हियर वी शैल डिस्कस सम इम्पोर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द ऑथर। William Douglas was an American writer. He was born in Maine, Minnesota. This lesson has been taken from his book of Man and Mountains. So let's we discuss some keyword which help us to understand the summary of this chapter. The keywords are subdued, means overcame; aversion, means dislike; panicky, means afraid; sucked, means inhaled; seized, means indent; dog, means part of port. Let's start the summary of this chapter. The author had an aversion for water since his childhood. When he was only 3 or 4 years old, his father took him to the beach in California. He and his father stood together in the waves. He hung on to his father, but the waves knocked him down and swept over him. He was frightened. His father laughed, but the waves created a fear in the author's mind. Now, when the author was 10 or 11 years old, he decided to learn to swim. There was a pool at the YMCA in Yakima. It offered him a good opportunity to learn swimming. One day, he took a pair of water wings and went to the pool. He was alone at the pool. He felt afraid to go into the water alone. He sat on the side of the pool. Just then a big 18-year-old boy came there. He picked up the author and threw him into the pool. The author was terrified, but he did not lose his presence of mind. He thought that when his feet touched the bottom of the pool, he would make a jump upwards and would come to the surface. Finally, he would lie flat on it and paddle to the end of the pool. But when he went down, the 9 feet seemed like 90 to him. But when his feet touched the bottom, he gathered courage and made a spring upwards. He came up rather slowly. Whenever he opened his eye, he saw water everywhere. He was suffocating. He became panicky. He tried to cry, but no words came out. His legs seemed paralyzed and were rigid. Instead of coming up, he went down and down. A great force seemed to pull him under water. He tried to scream but couldn't. Only his heart and pounding in his head showed that he was alive. He sucked for air but got water. He looked for ropes, ladder, water wings, but there was nothing except water. And then there was a light. He was coming out of the water. He felt that his eyes and nose were out of the water, but his mouth was still under water. Then he again found himself going down. He thought that he was going to die. He ceased all efforts. He felt as if he was going to become unconscious. After some time, Douglas regained consciousness. He found himself lying on his stomach near the pool. He was vomiting. The boy who had thrown him into the pool was standing near him. He was saying, "But I was only fooling." Someone said that Douglas had nearly died, but he was all right now. After some hours, he walked back to his home, but he was weak and his legs were trembling. But after that incident, a hunting fear remained in his heart. He never went back to the pool. He feared water and tried to avoid it. Finally, one October, he got an instructor. With him, he practiced for 5 days a week. The instructor taught him step by step how to swim. He taught him how to put his face under water and exhale, and then how to raise his nose and inhale. He repeated the exercise hundreds of times. Still, he wondered whether he would be terrified when he would be alone in a pool. In order to overcome his fear, the author went to Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire. He dived off a dock at Triggs Island. He swam 2 miles across the Lake Wentworth to Stump Act Island. Only once he felt some fear when he was in the middle of the lake, but soon he overcame that fear. Then he swam back. He shouted with joy. Thus, finally, he was able to conquer his fear of water and swimming. Thank you, friends. I hope it will help you to understand this chapter.